Can I say that from a perspective of a member of the New South Wales branch and a former official of the New South Wales Australian Labor Party, it has been very clear for some time that there is a problem with the culture and structures of the New South Wales branch. The structures have allowed a situation to develop whereby a small group have been able to have, who are a majority within a sub-faction, then go and get become a majority within a faction, and then impose their will on the party. Those structures must be reformed. The days of factional dominance in New South Wales must also be reformed because they have clearly led to an abuse of power. These reforms advanced by the Prime Minister today will do just that. What they do is will ensure that decisions are taken on merit. The situation whereby you could know the outcome of a meeting of the ALP Credentials Committee or the ALP Disputes Committee or the ALP Review Tribunal before the meeting was held has to end. These structural reforms will end that and hence end the power of those who are in a position to know the outcomes before the meetings are held. That's why this is the most significant reform into the New South Wales branch in 40 years. 40 years ago, when the reform established the review tribunal of the New South Wales branch, that was meant to do the job. Unfortunately, over a period of time, what happened was that the culture that had dominated the lower echelons of the branch went further up, and the same pattern of behaviour emerged, with consequences for the actions of Labor members of government. And we're seeing that played out in New South Wales at the moment. What these structures are necessary also through the National Executive, because the New South Wales branch isn't in a position to change its own rules. The National Executive must impose these rules in order for them to be done in a timely manner. And as a citizen of the great state of New South Wales, I believe that the electorate want these reforms to happen, and they want to see and actually see the response and the reality of a change in the way that the New South Wales Labor Party operates. So this reform imposed from the National Executive, the ALP Administrative Committee will remain in place for to oversee these changes, but they will be imposed at the national level in order to ensure that it gets done. We need to have the rights and responsibilities of every member of the Labor Party respected. Overwhelmingly, there has been such great disappointment from ALP rank and file members, the people who staffed the polling booths, the people who put things in letterboxes, the people who go out there and advocate at their local pub or their local footy team or the local PNC for the cause of Labor have been let down. What we are saying through these reforms is that your rights will be respected. Your work for the cause of Labor will be respected, and we'll put in place structures that ensure that the circumstances that we've seen recently in New South Wales can never happen again.